Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Mridul and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this video, we will learn how to work on the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect board using MicroPython. The Arduino RP2040 board comes with a pre-uploaded Blink sketch out of the box. To proceed with the MicroPython, we first need to enable the bootloader mode of the board. To do so, you need to short the ground and the reset pin and then power on the board. In my case, I am using a 2-pin short jumper, but you can also use a jumper wire. After shorting the pins, let's connect the board to our system. As you can see, the system automatically detects a drive folder. While keeping the board connected, unplug the shorted pins. Now we are in bootloader mode of the Arduino Nano RP2040. Firmware can be easily uploaded to the board by copy-pasting the corresponding UF2 file to the drive folder. In our case, we will use Thorny, a very popular IDE, to do the job for us. Open Thorny, open the Tools menu, then open Options. A dialog box will pop up. Select the interpreter. As we want to install MicroPython, we will select MicroPython Raspberry Pi Pico. After selecting the port, click on the Install or Update Firmware option. Now click on Install and wait for the installation to complete. As the firmware has been installed, let us now start tinkering with the board by creating a Blink sketch. Once you have completed the coding, always remember to save the code in the board drive. This will enable us to run the code on the Arduino Nano RP2040 and get serial data. After saving the code, click on Run. As we have given a sleep time of 1 second, the built-in LED blinks every second and the serial monitor displays the status of the LED. Now we will try to control the brightness and switching of an LED. To do so, let us first import the necessary modules. We import ADC, PIN and PWM from the machine module and sleep from the U-time module. We will create the objects starting from the potentiometer's analog input through GPIO26, then a digital input with pull-up resistor through GPIO20, and finally a PWM output through GPIO90. We will also predefine the state of the button false, indicating that the LED is off at the start. We will create an infinite while loop. After doing so, first, check for whether the tactile button was pressed. When a digital pin is declared as pull-up, then the high and low logic gets reversed. This means that the button's value will be false when pressed and true when untouched. If the button is pressed, the function pointer should call a function that will return the changed state of the state variable. We will print the state to know whether the LED is on or off. We have made the code for switch input, so let us now make the analog input an LED code. First, check whether the state is true or not. If it is true, the function will read the potentiometer's analog data and store it into a volt variable. Then, we will write the command to output the volt value as a PWM signal to the LED. We will also write a command to display the PWM output voltage in the serial monitor. However, if the state is false, it will provide a PWM output of value 0, that is, a 0 volt output. Do not forget to provide a sleep timing as per your requirement. We have completed the coding part, so now we will save the code to the board's folder. After doing so, let us just run the code. As you can see, the LED is in an off state, so I will turn it on by clicking the tactile button. Now, the LED should be on and will glow as per the potentiometer value. As I turn the potentiometer's knob clockwise, the brightness increases, and when I turn it anti-clockwise, the brightness decreases. Also, if I press the tactile switch again, the LED turns off. For the code and the circuit diagrams, check out the video's description. As of now, MicroPython only supports the basic functions of Arduino Nano RP2040 board and not the functionalities of the built-in peripherals. We are uploading the Raspberry Pi Pico's UF2 file to the Arduino Nano RP2040 as both the boards have the same RP2040 microcontroller unit. Arduino Nano RP2040 can function fully with MicroPython when the MicroPython developers provide a dedicated UF2 file for this board. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.